Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So students, in our previous video we have covered exercise 7.6 and today I am going to start the introduction of exercise 7.7 in which we'll discuss about the integration of some special type of integrals. But before that, those who want to see the solution of the previous exercise, they can just click in the I link. The description of the playlist of that exercise is given in that link. So without wasting the time, let's see what are the special type of integrals which we are going to use in exercise 7.6 and how to do the integration of those integrals. So let's see, there are specifically three types of integrals in this exercise, and student, these are very important for chapter number 8 also, because these formulas you are going to use in chapter number 8 also, that is applications of integrals. So please understand these questions and these integrals and how to do the integration of this type, please very carefully. So the first is square root of under root of a square minus x square, integration of this. We will specifically discuss the integration of these three types of integrals, that is square root of a square minus x square. The second one is square root of x square minus a square dx, and the third one is square root of x square plus a square dx. So students, these two are specifically same. The only difference is that here we are having negative sign and here we are having positive sign. So I'll just solve one and you can solve the other by same process. So we will start from this first. This is the first type of integral. So I'm just rubbing here. So let's see. We can do the integration of this type of integral by two methods. Either we can use Islet method, that is integration by parts, or we can use substitution method. We can put x is equal to a sin theta or cos theta, whatever you want you can use here. You can put x is equal to a sin theta also, but I am just using directly integration by parts. So first of all, we will let this given integral as I. Now you know that here we are actually integrating the function which is quadratic equation, but it is in the square root. That is square root of a quadratic equation, and it can be either of the three types which I have discussed earlier. So for applying Islet method, that is integration by parts, we need two functions, but here we are having only one function. So for that I will put one here. Those students who want to understand what is Islet method and how to do the integration by parts, please see in the description box, the link is given over there, and you can also click on the I link. The description is also given over there. You can see in the playlist about the integration by part process and how to do this type of integrals. So by that method, we will just take this function as first function. We will take this function as first function, and we will take this function as second function. Why I am taking one as a second function? Because if you know that integration by part process, we have to take first function as it is an integration of second function. So out of these two functions, we have to think about which function to be taken as first function and which function is to be taken as second function. Out of these two functions, we will take that function as second function. For those, we can do the integration very easily. So you can see here that we can't do the integration of this function. Actually, we are also deriving this, the integration of this function. So we'll take one as a second function because it is very easy to do the integration of one, that is equal to x. So students, applying integration by parts, let's see the formula for integration by part is first function as it is into integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function, that is d by dx of square root of a square minus x square, into integration of second function and whole dx. So this is the formula of the integration by parts. As you know that the integration of this is actually into integration of 1 with respect to x become x. So we can write down here at as x into square root of a square minus x square. Now we will do the derivative of this function. The derivative of square root of x a square minus x square will be equal to 1 upon 2 square root of a square minus x square. And by applying the chain rule, the derivative of a square will be equal to 0 and the derivative of minus x square will be equal to minus 2x. Also, the integration of 1 with respect to x become x. So, students, please cancel whatever you can cancel 2 by 2. Now, in the next step, what we are going to get? X square root of a square minus x square and negative negative become positive. So x into x become x square, square root of a square minus x square. Now you can just do like that, take negative negative. Because in the next step, we are having a square minus x square in the denominator. So I am going to make a square minus x square in the numerator also. How? Let's see. So students, in this process, I am going to add 1 a square and going to subtract 1 a square just to make in the form of denominator, that is a square minus x square. What I have done here, I have added a square as well as subtracted a square. So in the next process, this is actually equal to I, the whole process is equal to the I. X square root a square minus x square minus, now we will split this integral into two parts, that is a square minus x square upon square root of a square minus x square, a square minus x square upon square root of a square minus x square dx. And students, this negative negative become positive. So positive and a square is a constant, so you can take it outside and inside we get only 1 upon square root of a square minus x square. So students, next process is that you can see here that I can cancel square root of a square minus x square by this a square minus x square. So I am going to get root of a square minus x square. One root will be cancelled and we will get only one root. And this is actually the integration of some specific type of integrals which we have done in exercise 7.3. So again, I am reminding those who want to see the solution of the previous exercise, exercise 7.3, exercise 7.6, please click on the I link and you can get the description of the all the videos related to this chapter. So students, from that specific type of integrals, we get the formula, that is integration of 1 upon square root of a square minus x square is equal to 1 is equal to sine inverse x upon a. These formulas you have done in some specific type of integrals. So students, this is actually equal to I. And in the next step, what you observe that we are doing the integration of square root of a square minus x square. And this function automatically becomes I. So we will just substitute this integral as I. This is actually equal to the complete I, which is we have taken in the starting. And this is equal to a square sine inverse x upon a plus c. This minus I will be shifted to the left hand side and I plus I becomes 2i is equal to x square root of x square minus a square plus a square sine inverse x upon a plus c. Now students, in the next step, this 2 will come in the denominator and it will come in the division. So basically it becomes x upon 2 square root of, this is actually a square minus x square. I have taken x square minus a square. So this is a square minus x square. Now I will tell you shortcut trick to remember all the formulas also. Plus this also 2 will come in the division, so it becomes a square upon 2 sine inverse x upon a. and this is basically a constant, so you can take C1 also. When this 2 will come in the division, so it becomes C1 upon 2, which can be taken as a new constant C, where C is equal to C1 upon 2. C is equal to C1 upon 2. So students, this is the formula for the integration of square root of a square minus x square, that is x upon 2, this function as it is, plus a square upon 2, sin inverse x upon a plus c. This formula is very, very important for chapter number 8. In mostly questions, you are going to use this formula. Please note down. So students, in the next part or next second formula, that is integration of square root of x square minus x square. Previously we have done a square minus x square, now it is actually x square minus a square. So how to do this? Same process I am going to use, that is integration by parts. So I will take one as a first, I will take one in the multiplication, and this will be equal to second function and this will be equal to first function. So integrating by parts using Eilert method, see students, we are having, and this function you always have to take as I. Okay, so now you will take, when you will do the integration by parts, apply the formula of integration by parts, that is first function as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function, that is square root of a x square minus a square, into integration of second function dx. So students, in the next process, you know that integration of one is x. So I'll get here x into square root of x square minus a square minus, the integration of this function will be 1 upon 2 root x square minus a square, and again the integration of x square minus a square by using chain rule will be equal to 2x, because the integration of a square becomes 0, this is actually a constant, and the integration of 1 with respect to x becomes x. So in the next step, you can cancel 2 by 2. Same process, you can just understand, same process we have done in the previous question also. So students, see here, x into x becomes x square upon square root of x square minus a square. So students, I am just applying all the methods same which we have applied in the first integral also. For doing the integration, I will make, I am having a x square minus a square in the denominator. So I am going to make same function in the numerator also. How can I make it? Just adding a square and subtracting a square. It is very simple. In the previous question also, in the previous integral also, we have done the same step. We have added 1 a square and subtracted 1 a square just to make the function in the form of denominator. Now, next step is, this x square minus a square will be splitted, and in the denominator we are having x square, square root of x square minus a square dx, and this plus into minus becomes minus, and a square is a constant, so you can take it outside, and we get only 1 upon square root of x square minus a square, because a square we have taken outside, so we get 1 as a numerator in this integral. So students, this is actually equal to I. In the next step, you can see again we get the integral, so we can cancel this square root of x square minus a square by this function, and we get only square root of x square minus a square dx minus a square, again following the formula of some special type of integrals. So we get the formula for this is equal to log x plus square root of x square minus a square plus the constant of integration c, but I am taking c1, why, just let's see. Again, as in the previous question, when you have done the integration, you get the same function as you are having in the starting. So this is actually equal to I. You can do the transposition method. Transposition method is just, you will just put the value of this is equal to I and shifting this I on the left hand side. See students, this is actually equal to I. log x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c1. Now this minus I will be shifted to left hand side, so I plus I becomes 2i. So 2i is equal to x square root of x square minus a square log x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c1. Now when these two will come in the division, so I is equal to x upon 2 square root x square minus a square upon 2 log x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c1 upon 2, which becomes a new constant c. So students, the formula of this integration will be equal to x upon 2 square root of x square minus a square minus of a square. See students, if a square is negative, so we are having negative a square. If a square is positive, then we are having plus a square. Log x plus this function as it is. Please note down. So students, I hope so that you have noted this function, that is integration of x square minus a square. In the third part, I am going to do the integration of x square plus a square. So students, I have not erased this because I am just going to tell you that this is the same process you are going to do. Just replace minus by plus. So you get minus by plus, and this is where we are having plus. Plus, plus. Now when you will make the pair, what happen? We are having x square plus a square in the denominator. So we will make the pair of x square plus a square. So when you will make the pair of x square plus a square, then we will get minus minus as plus a square. So we get plus a square. The only difference is that only. So now this will be cancelled by this. And we get square root of x square plus a square. Only in place of negative we will do positive. Everywhere, wherever we are having a square, we will just replace a square by minus a square, that is minus minus becomes plus. So here we get the formula, that is x upon 2 square root of x square plus a square upon 2 log x plus square root of x square plus a square. This is as simple, same process you have to follow in both the integrals. So students, I hope so that you have understood all the formulas which I have discussed here. Basically these are three special type of integrals, which is a quadratic equation in the form of a square root. So these formulas we are going to use in the solution of next exercise, that is 7.7. Hope so that you have understood and like my video. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes.